Now, I'm joined here in Beijing by Jim McGregor. He's a longtime China analyst, lived here for about 20 years, author of 1 Billion Customers. Mr. McGregor, thanks for the time. What's riding on this visit for Barack Obama?
I think Obama's just here to kind of suss out the Chinese and see if he can try to develop personal relationships with the leaders, because that's the only thing that's going to solve the problems over the years. Clinton did it before him. George Bush Sr. did it before him. They want to know who they're talking to.
And for the Chinese perspective, what do they hope to get out of this at the end of the day? Do we expect any substantive agreements on issues like currency?
No, there's going to be no agreements on anything, currency, Iran, nukes, North Korea. It's basically just to figure each other out. This is a new president. He's a Democrat. They don't know what to think of him. They don't know what his trade policies are going to be. He's already done this anti-surge from WTO, which scared them on tires. So the relationship has changed because the world financial crisis has made the Chinese economy more important than ever to the world and to the United States. And they got to see where they sit eye to eye or where they don't agree.
And where they don't agree, where do you think the issues are intractable? Where is it the United States and China is really going to have trouble over the next little bit?
Well, they always have trouble on ideological grounds because the Chinese, America pushes human rights a lot, and China's saying we're a developing country. We can't do all the things you think we should do. I think on working on the global stage together, there's talk of a G2. That drives China crazy because they're used to being on the back of the stage in the shadows maneuvering and getting things done. And now the way the world's changed, they're on the front of the stage and they're not very comfortable there. They're very nervous.
One final question for you. I've heard some suggest that climate change, energy technology, that's one area where these two nations really do have shared interests, can reach agreements there. Do you buy that?
I would hope so. I think on climate change we could. One of the problems is intellectual property rights protection. The technology companies from the U.S. are afraid of bringing their best green technology here and having it stolen. So it gets right back into trade issues even on that.
All right, Jim McGregor, appreciate it very much. And that's the latest from here in Beijing. We'll be following the president over the next 3 days.